Salam alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters and dear friends. Hope you guys are doing well. Before I start, I want to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the most just. All praises, glory and gratitude belong to Him. As you guys know, a couple of months ago maybe, I released a refutation video of my teacher refuting me because I made a few mistakes while doing wudu. Or maybe Sheikh wanted me to be a bit more precise. So obviously, this video has been long awaited. Not like the marriage documentary, but we're going to get straight into it, inshallah. What we're going to do is we're going to show you how to do wudu the way the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam done it. So we've got the towel, we need a towel, to dry ourselves.
Okay.
We have got water.
Yeah.
We're going to come to why we have this much water and not too much water. And what else do we need, Sheikh?
Nothing, we need just a bucket as well. Yeah, to keep the
with wudu. The bucket, yeah?
Before we start the wudu, in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to start our wudu with bismillah. Okay. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "La salata min ghayr tuhur, wa la tuhur min lam yadhkar ismu Allah." There is no salah without a tuhur, without a ghusl or wudu, and the tuhur as well is not perfect until the person remember the name of Allah to say Bismillah.
Is that so, sunnah or fard?
The scholars they differ on that about the wudu. We say that it is fard to say Bismillah for the wudu, but if someone forgets, still his wudu is valid.
Okay,
that's how.
Okay. So am I doing it first or are you doing it first?
I will do it first, inshallah.
Okay.
We'll
right, so is there any reason why we're using this much water?
We use it because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said لا تصرف في الماء ولو كنت على نهر جاري, which means do not exaggerate in spending the water or wasting the water, even if you are on a running river.
Okay, let's see if we can finish our wudu with. Well, you.
Yeah, inshallah ta'ala.
Okay. This also depends on me, how much I pour. So we have to work together,
yeah, inshallah ta'ala. I could do it, inshallah, myself, inshallah ta'ala. So you don't bother yourself, inshallah ta'ala.
Oh, you're on yourself, yeah?
Yeah, inshallah. Okay. Inshallah.
Okay, so after you do it, I'm going to attempt it, yeah?
Inshallah ta'ala.
You came to this ward alone, and you're going to leave alone.
Now, generally, that we start by washing our hands, that to clean our hands firstly, to clean our hands before we start. Allah Azza wa told us that there are main pillars of the wudu, washing the face, yeah, including the mouth and the nose,
yeah,
and then after that washing the hand up to the elbows,
yeah,
and then wiping on the head, then including the ears, and washing the feet. That's what generally it is.
Okay, so washing your hands is not a part of it, but it's sunnah.
It is sunnah to start.
Just
to
by start. Washing your hands.
Yeah,
but the main part is your face you start with.
The main part is Allah will start with the face.
Okay, okay.
Bismillah.
A specific reason why you're doing this?
Just to clean the hand, that's how it
is. Is it the Prophet ﷺ do like this? Or
there are narrations that the, yep, Prophet ﷺ, he was washing his hand, alayhi salatu wasalam, and that's how we copied, yeah, from our mashayikh,
yeah,
from our scholars who we learn from.
Sheikh, I think you're going to need more water than that. I don't know, I'm a bit skeptical right now. Okay, Sheikh, so you're doing the mouth and the nose separate.
Yeah.
Did the Prophet ﷺ do it together at any point?
He did together and he did separate.
Okay, alright. Just so people know. Okay. So you can either, the brothers and sisters, either do it one at a time, mouth first and nose. And or do it together with the nose and mouth.
Yeah. And it's important that the face is from the hip all the way, and including that's the head, including here. Yeah, that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he used to do takhlil, which means he used to make his fingers goes through
his beard. So the face is not just it's not over the chin, it's under the chin.
As well, yeah.
So brothers and sisters, as you can see here, like for example, sometimes we get mistake. If I'm not mistaken, and we think this is the face. I don't know about the opinion, by the way, but what we've been told here is that the face is all the way up to the under the chin here. So where the beard is, if I'm not mistaken. So that's the face. Yeah, so okay, we've got the elbows here now. We're doing the hands. We're doing the elbows now. So, Chef, when we talk about the elbow, are we just, where is the line? Do we do it up to here? Or should we go a bit more above just to be on the safe side? Because you know a lot of people suffer from waswasa.
Yeah.
And they start, you know, thinking, oh no, did I do the wudu? You know.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, اسمع الوضوء عن المكاره. Which means the elbow is included. As long as you wash the elbow,
yeah,
with it, then it's fine as well.
Okay. Okay, so when you do the hair check, where's it up to? Where do we stop here?
the back of the head to the neck.
The back of the head and going forward. That's how it is. It will be sufficient, all the head like this, it will be sufficient. And it is sunnah to go back with it. And then the ears with it.
Yeah.
The ear are part of it. Yeah.
Okay.
And then this is the hard part.
This is the hard part, yeah?
Yeah.
How is the easy part?
No, inshallah. Bismillah.
So when washing the feet, does it have to be up to the...
Up to the ankle.
You need to do it in between...
And the finger. Between the toes with your pinky finger. And we're done. Alhamdulillah. Still there's water.
As you can see, brothers and sisters, we still got just under half left. Now, if I'm saying actually, there might be just about half. So if we can do it, you can do it as well. So should I have a go, Sheikh?
Can you do that?
Oh, with this, yeah? Yeah, I can do it. Okay, here we go. I was thinking I was going to get a fresh one. Okay, let's do it. Let's say you woke up, you've done this, yeah? You've done your wudu properly, and you've done your ankles. Yeah. You put your socks on, yeah? And let's imagine you broke your wudu, yeah? So what we're going to do is from now, we're going to go...
So as long as if you put your... you put your socks on the status of wudu,
yeah,
then your wudu will be sufficient.
Okay, yeah, so like I said before, so I put my socks on, let's suppose, after wudu, so I'm going to start like that, yeah? It's a face, yeah?
Yeah, then mouth.
No.
And the Tabi'een, you do need to make your socks wet. Okay. The Sahaba, they used to make lines. What's the meaning of this?
Okay.
They used to make lines. They used to do like that in the Masjid.
One at a time?
You could do both. The best thing is to do both like this. Then it will be enough for you.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a tradition that the Salaf, they used to make lines in the Masjid.
Mm.
Okay. Which means the lines, of course, and then with fingers.
Do I need to get more water or with these hands?
No, put a bit of water in.
Okay, and I'm going to ask you a question, and maybe you can reply how Ali radiallahu anhu replied.
Yeah.
Why do we not wipe underneath our socks at the top?
Yeah, because we take
like these guys, as you can see.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. Not get soap and wash your socks. Yeah,
that's it.
Sheikh, why not the bottom, why the top?
Because we take the religion of Islam according to the Quran and the Sunnah, not according to our aql, not according to our intellect. That's right. And the Prophet, he did Masah on top, we do Masah on top.
Yeah.
As simple as that.
I think you need to teach me how to dry my hands. So guys,
at least we still have some water even.
If you guys want, you can come and join us and do wudu.
Alhamdulillah, there is some water which is left.
We might get the cameraman to try as well now.
Alhamdulillah, there is some water, which means it's possible.
It's possible. Yes.
For both of us, I think it's less than...
Yeah.
I think, I don't know if it's 400 milli or 300 milli, and there's still something left.
Can we use the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ? So, you know, food that's enough for one is enough for two?
No, that's not
true. Okay, we stay away from that,
yeah.
Inshallah. Brothers and sisters, that's about it. Hope you guys have benefited and learned how to do wudu properly. And do share it with your friends and family. That's about it from me and Sheikh Mohammed. Till next time, if there's any other videos that you want to learn more about Islam, whatever it may be, let us know and we will inshallah try to bring that to you. Till next time, goodbye.